YouTube. It's great, Brad. Well, election season's on us again. See the signs on the streets and in front of the houses. So I'm kind of dreading this because there's so much negativity in there. And I really miss the positive change message of Obama. So for old time's sake, I watched a video from 2008, and this one was Gore Vidal versus Dimbleby. It was when Obama was newly elected president and there was euphoria, and they were discussing the election and Republicans in general. So I don't know who to vote for, because as an American citizen, I don't know about democracy anymore, because we had this bailout in 2008, and I was one of the people that called Washington to complain, to say, no, don't bail out these idiots. Well, 100-1 people said no, but they did it anyway, and they keep bailing out these too big to fail idiots, and we have to bail them out. And what I'm hearing now is, oh, we have to cut social spending, so now I have to be older to get Social Security, and my benefits will not be as much, they will not keep up for inflation. And that doesn't seem fair. And then I watch Michael Moore. And Michael Moore says that we have the richest 1% in America now, who have as much financial wealth as the bottom 95% combined. And I start getting a little mad, because I think about all the rich people in Congress that we pay their salaries and their health care, and they have all this wonderful stuff, and we just seem to have to pay everything, and we get cut. So when I was watching Gore Vidal, and I have great respect for Gore Vidal, he knows so much about Washington. I have it in the link if this is not accepted, because it's a 2-year-old video. But Gore Vidal was very happy that Obama got elected, and he said some things about the Republican Party. And what struck me was that Gore Vidal said the Republican Party is more of a mindset now. And what does that mean? And he said that the Republican Party love money. They're out to keep their connections with the Bushes and the elite in this country. And you think about how rich Congress is. And my own congressman, Dennis Hassert. When Dennis Hassert first came to Washington as a humble coach, his net worth was less than $500,000 a year. I think it was like $300,000. And he left after the Bush administration, between $6 and $7 million he was worth. So it's really makes me angry. So I think I'm going to send this video to Washington, to my representatives. But I want to close with something that a Republican said that I liked. A Republican who was a 5-star general. A Republican who the world loved. I like Ike. I still like Ike. This is what he said. I hate war as only a soldier who has lived it can. As one who has seen its brutality, its futility, and its stupidity. Every gun that is made, every warship launched, every rocket fired, signifies, in the final sense, theft. Theft from the American people. From those who hunger and are not fed. From those who are cold and are not clothed. This from a 4-star general and president of the United States and a Republican. So I wonder, how did the Republicans get this way? I have my own ideas, but I think it'd be good discussing this. Thanks, YouTube.